Hello everyone, welcome to the science video class. So today we are going to study chapter number 14, electric current and its effect. Through this video we are going to study about the heating effect of electric current, electric fuse, MCB, magnetic effect of electric currents, electromagnets and electric bell. Now you might have seen an electrician or the elders at home removing a lighted bulb from its holder by holding it with a handkerchief or a piece of cloth. Why do they do so? Undoubtedly, because it becomes hot. Have you ever thought why a bulb, when lighted, becomes hot? Well, it is due to the heating effect of electric current. When an electric current passes through the current-carrying conductors, it becomes hot. This is called as heating effect of electric current. Many devices, just like iron ovens, geysers, toasters, etc. and many more, they all work on the basis of heating effect of electric current. They have a coiled wire called element, which on passing the electric current becomes red hot and gives out heat. Different materials get heated to different extents on passing the electric current through them, and this is due to the property called resistance. Now you must are wondering that what is this resistance is all about. Resistance comes from the word resist, which means to hinder or to oppose. So resistance can be defined as a property by which an object offers hindrance or opposition to current flow in an electric circuit. It hampers the flow of current through a material. Materials having high resistance like tungsten and nichrome produces large amount of heat, and this is the reason why tungsten is used in the manufacturing of the filament of the bulb. You know, as I said, tungstens have high resistance property, and in a minute or a fraction of minutes it becomes so hot that it start emitting the light. This is the reason why tungsten is used in the manufacturing of the filament of the bulb. Now materials having low resistance like silver or aluminium and copper produces less amount of heat, and this is the reason why they are used in the manufacturing of the electrical wires. Now, what are the factors on which heat produced by the element depends? Well, there are four factors on which the heat produced by the element depends upon. Number one, the materials of the element. As I discussed earlier, higher the resistance, more will be the heat produced. Lower the resistance, less will be the heat produced, right? Now, second point, the length of the wire in the element. Again, as the length of the wire increases, the amount of heat produced also increases. Third point, the thickness of the wire in the element. Now, the amount of heat produced is inversely proportional to the thickness of the wire of the element. How? Let me explain. Now, when the wire is thicker, it has more number of electrons to conduct or transfer the electric charge or electric current through it. So, it will offer low resistance, and due to this it becomes less hot. Okay, and when the wire is thinner, it has less number of electrons to do the same work, and it offers the maximum resistance, and this is the reason why the thinner wire becomes more hot. Now the last but not the least point is the time for which the current flows. Now if the current is flows through a circuit for a large amount of time, then the wire or the conducting element will become more hot as compared to the circuit in which the current flows for a lesser time. Now we'll start with the electric fuse. What is electric fuse? It is a safety device which limits the current in an electric device. Okay, so here in the diagram I have shown you a common type of electric fuse. Okay, as you can see in the picture, It consists of a porcelain holder fitted with two metallic terminals. A thin wire is made of tin, or an alloy of tin or copper is screwed between these terminals. When the holder is in position, the current flows in the circuit. Now, why? What is the application of this electric fuse? Where is this electric fuse used and for what? So here I am going to tell you about the working of the electric fuse, or the application of the electric fuse in our daily life. You know, production of heat in any circuit is a very normal behavior. Sometimes a circuit may get overheated due to overloading. In this situation, the fuse wire melts a little before any other part of the circuit could. So this stops the flow of current, and further heating or burning of the circuit is prevented. And this saves us from disasters like electrical wire fires, and save us from the threat of fire, and protects us from the danger situation. Now, another thing that we could use for the same safety device is MCB. MCB stands for the miniature circuit breaker. Here I have shown you the picture of MCBs that you have already seen in your homes. It is an alternative to an electric fuse. It is convenient to use, as it automatically turns off when the current in the circuit crosses the safe limit. To complete the circuit again, we have to turn it on instead of replacing the melted wire as in the electric fuse. So MCB is more convenient than the electrical fuse, and these days commonly MCBs are used in our homes as compared to the fuses. Now let us start with the magnetic effect of electric current. It may sound astonishing to begin with, but it is true that the electric current has a magnetic effect too. The magnetic effect of electricity was first studied by a Danish chemist and physicist, Hans Christian Oersted, in 1820, and he laid the foundation of electromagnetism. When an electric current is passed in a conductor, it develops a magnetic field around it and behaves like a magnet. The phenomena of developing a magnetic field around a conductor on passing the electric current through it is called magnetic effect of electricity, and the combined effect of electricity and the magnetism is called electromagnetism. Also, the study of electromagnets is known as electromagnetism. Now, how is electromagnet made up of? An electromagnet is a solenoid with a soft iron core. Now you must be wondering, what is solenoid is all about? Solenoid is a cylindrical coil of wire acting as a magnet when carrying an electric current. Okay, so here in the diagram I have shown you the picture of bar type electromagnet and horseshoe type electromagnet. The arrangement behaves like a magnet when current is passed through it. An electromagnet consists of an insulated copper wire coiled around a soft iron bar. When the current is passed through this coil, the whole system behaves like a magnet, and it is a temporary magnet. Now, why it is a temporary magnet? It is called as temporary magnet because along with the current, the magnetism can also be switched off or on. So when the current is passed through this coil, the whole system behaves like a magnet, and as soon as the current through the coil is switched off, the magnetic property of the electromagnetism also disappears. So it is called as temporary magnet, and depending upon the shape of the iron core, an electromagnet can be a bar electromagnet or a U-shaped electromagnet as shown in the diagram. Now, what are the factors on which the strength of electromagnet depends upon? So there are three factors on which the strength or the power of electromagnet depends upon. Number one, nature of the core materials. Iron makes better electromagnet as compared to the other elements. In fact, iron is the best material to make an electromagnet. Number two, number of turns of the copper wire. More turns of the wire means more electromagnetism. Less turns of the wire means less electromagnetism. Number three, magnitude of the current. Greater the current, stronger is the electromagnetism. And smaller will be the current, weaker is the electromagnetism. Now, let us discuss about the various uses of electromagnet. There are lots of uses of electromagnets, but I have listed some uses here only. Number one, to separate iron scrap from the junk in the industry. There are some industries which works on the iron, which works on collecting the iron scrap from the junks. So there, to separate the larger or the heavier iron scrap from the junk, electromagnets are used. Number two, they are used in the receivers of telephones and electric motors. Number three, they are used in relay switches and electric bells. Number four, they are the important part of picture tubes of television and computer screens. Electromagnets help in the formation of images on the screen. Number three, magnetic levitation. Very strong electromagnets are used to run the fastest running train, which is maglev train, which runs at a speed of more than 400 kilometers. You know, these trains run on a track with electromagnets on them. The magnets repel each other and the trains are able to achieve high speeds due to very little friction. So these are the some uses of electromagnets. So let us start with the commonly used electromagnet in every sphere of our life, which is the electric bell. So electric bell has an electromagnet inside it and works on the magnetic effect of electric bulb. So let us start with its structure. So first we are discussing the structure of electric bell. As you can see in the diagram, an electric bell consists of the following parts. Number one, an electromagnet. There is a U-shaped electromagnet whose one end is connected to terminal T1 and other end is connected to the brass stud. Second part is armature. It is a soft iron strip which is attracted by the electromagnet when magnetized. Third part is hammer. It is a small metallic sphere which is made up of steel attached to the armature at its one end. It strikes the gong to produce the sound. Fourth part is gong. It is a metallic hemisphere to which the hammer strike to produce the sound. And the last part is the contact screw. It is also known as a make or a break screw, which is adjustable. So as the name indicates, it will make or break the circuit. It is connected to the terminal T2 by the copper wire. It is used to attach the contact between the armature and the push button of the bell to produce the bass sound. So now we are going to discuss that how this electric bell works. Okay, so you can see in the picture, please concentrate on the diagram so that the working will be more understandable. So number one point is, the terminals T1 and T2 are connected to a battery or energy source through a push button and switch. In homes and schools, generally an electric bell is connected to the electric source instead of a battery. Okay, so when the switch is pushed on, the current flows through the electromagnet and the contact screw. As a result, the electromagnet is magnetized and attracts the armature. The hammer connected at the end of the armature moves through it the gong and produces a sound. This time, the contact between the contact spring and the contact screw breaks. As the circuit breaks, the electromagnets get demagnetized. the coil is no longer a magnet. The armature moves back, the circuit is made again, and as a result, the above steps are repeated. The bell goes on ringing until the push button is released. So, this is how an electric bell works. So, now we have finished with the chapter number 14, electric current and its effects. Thank you for watching the video.